Well, last night, over 15 million of us tuned in to see the brilliant Matt Cardle crowned X Factor winner 2010.
I'm a painter by trade every now and again, but I'm a bit of a bum if I'm honest.
I really, really like you.
You're in my top three!
Yeah.
Absolutely incredible.
It doesn't get any better than that.
Matt, you got the laugh. That was brilliant. I was like, snog, whoa. Snog.
So was I.
Welcome and congratulations.
Thank you so much, thank you.
I mean, you look back at that time and you walked in at that first audition and you were kind of quite sort of self-deprecating in a way. You're like, yeah, I'm just this normal guy. This isn't the sort of life that I lead. Yeah. Can I do this? And you've never really believed that it would be possible, really, have you?
Yeah, I mean, you see it happen to other people and... When you want something that bad, it's hard to imagine getting it, you know?
Yeah.
It really is hard when it's that much of a dream. And like you mentioned, I'm still the same guy who walked in there on that first audition, kind of not knowing what to expect. And, you know, I'm him, it's me.
Yeah.
Without the hat.
Just without the hat and a bit more makeup and less sweaty. But no.
But I suppose you can't allow yourself to think that it might happen, because if it didn't happen, then I suppose the disappointment would be huge.
It would be devastating. I mean, you every now and again you flirt with the idea of getting it, and the more the competition rolled on, you know, the closer I got to the end, you know, the more I would flirt with the idea, and as soon as you think, you're like, no. Come on, be serious.
Well, we've got the list of the statistics after it's always released afterwards. Mm-hmm. Who was in the lead throughout the voting? First week, Mary was first, and you were second, and then from then on, every other week from week two onwards, you were first. You and Mary for the first three weeks. And then Cher, when she sang Stay, was second. And then Rebecca for a couple of weeks. Then Katie, when she sang Help. And then Rebecca again. So you wouldn't have known that, but pretty well, right from the word go, you looked like the clear winner.
Well, that's just absolutely amazing. I mean, people were saying to me quite a lot, you know, that I was a favourite and things like that. And I wasn't believing that. You can't believe the hype. Just keep your head down and do your best every week. I mean, if I'd known that, I don't know if I would have gone out and relaxed a bit more, if I would have, you know, put more pressure on myself. I'm kind of glad I didn't.
Did you manage, because last night the pressure on you must have been so huge, and when you just keep getting onto the next stage and the next stage, I mean, how did you manage to hold it together?
I was really just treating each, well, especially the final, just like another week, like another weekend show. Go on. You know, have your little chat beforehand and afterwards and do your song, do the best you can do at
the
time.
But you were battling with being ill as well.
I know, and it wasn't the ideal situation, but it happens. It was, you know, a touch of laryngitis and, you know, tracheitis and stuff like that. But when you're singing, some people are really
ill. Hey, it's a touch of laryngitis.
I know.
Your whole future depended on your throat.
I know. And it was so frustrating. But, I mean, Danny said to me before I went on, she said, you know what, you can't change it now. And when I was doing the Take That song, I wasn't thinking about it because it wasn't my song. And she said, you relaxed then and your voice came back, you know. And then I did it for this. I mean, I didn't perform once how I think I could have done. And I'm never happy with it.
Really? Even Nights in White Satin, which was my favourite performance of the whole competition.
I really enjoyed it. Some of the overall performances, but looking back vocally, I mean, I just want perfection.
Yeah.
And if you constantly strive for perfection, you'll never achieve it, but you'll constantly improve. And I'm a firm believer of that. But it just means that you come off stage kicking yourself.
So that moment last night, 15 million people waiting to find out what was going to happen. What were you thinking at that moment?
I was, when it got down to me, One Direction and Rebecca, once One Direction had gone, I was completely convinced that Rebecca had it. So I was trying to kind of celebrate for her across the stage. I was trying to catch her eye and be like, babe, you've got it, but she was like head down. I was like, right, head down. And then Dermot said me, and it, you know, it's when you get, you know, some news in your life or something like that, something with that gravitas, and you just, your whole world goes dong, and you, you know, your hearing's all suppressed. There's a kind of a whining in your ears, and I was just like,
well, nothing is going to be the same again, really, is it? You know that. I mean, you've come in today. It's a little bit like the Prime Minister when the old Prime Minister goes to Buckingham Palace with his entourage, and then you know he says goodbye to the Queen, and he goes out on his own on the bus.
Yeah.
You know, arrived this morning. You've got your team around you now.
Hello.
The people who are going to look after you and guide you through what will be an unbelievable schedule.
Oh God, yeah. I mean, I had a little peek at it, and then it was like, but it's, like I said to you earlier, it's what I've wanted to do. I want to be busy. I'm sick of bumming around the skate park and, you know, around the pub and stuff, and I just want to crack on and work.
Well, if Harry from One Direction is to be believed, you've got a lovely time ahead of you.
No, it was a cat. That was a cat. You've got a big contract coming up, and Harry mentioned, I suppose, obviously the first thing you wanted was a cat.
Well, absolutely, he knows me.
Because he whispered in your ear, just think of the lovely cat that you're going to get.
Oh,
now.
He's a cheeky
boy. That might not have been exactly the words.
He's
in trouble
he's
with
young.
His mother this morning. That's all
so
I'm going
to
say.
So, just to confirm, that is indeed, and if you missed it, I'm not going to repeat it, but that is indeed what he said.
He was being cheeky.
Yes. Yeah, he's going to have a clip round his ear from his mum.
Certainly will. Is.
And talking about clip round the ear, a knock round the head. You nearly knocked
I
Danny's
know.
Sparker.
Smacked Danny in the face.
I know. I felt so bad watching it.
Let's
back.
Have a little look.
Are we going to watch it?
Yeah, we're make you believe it.
But boff!
I almost just cleared
it. Oh no! Oh no! Oh no!
That's really terrible.
It was.
I have just tweeted an apology to her about that. I was just. Full on, wasn't it?
To smack your mentor.
She's been great, hasn't she?
She's been amazing, yeah. I can't thank her enough. She's going to get a great Christmas present for me when I finally get the chance to get out to a shop.
And Christmas, I mean, is that going to happen for you this year? Or are you just going to be working, working, working? Is there a point when you can stop?
I think Christmas Day. I mean, I think I'm pretty full on straight up to Christmas. Otherwise, I'll just be sat around otherwise. Yeah.
It's what you wanted.
This is what I wanted. Yeah.
And how did it feel to get your CD in your hand?
Oh, amazing! Just absolutely amazing. I know it's a cover and whatnot, but it's
a great
still,
single.
It is.
It's
I mean,
a beautiful song.
It really is, and it's been. I think it was quite an underrated song. Mm. I think it's absolutely beautifully written, and it's a great. It's just such a great track, and I hope people you know don't hate on it because it's affiliated with X Factor. You know, I want people to just see the song for what it is. I know it's not the original.
Yeah.
It's almost the original.
Well, I like
much
the fact that... not the first person to do a cover, mate. Mm. The great thing is that you and Rebecca had different songs
yeah,
to
sure.
sing this time. So things that suited your voice rather than have to adapt. And let's have a listen.
I think that was a good idea.
Out now.
Mm-hmm.
Colleen's in the hub. You got some questions for us, Colleen?
Oh, loads of questions for Matt. I spent a fortune on you last night. I just want you to know that. Lindsay in Birmingham says, how will you react if there is a campaign to prevent your song from getting to the Christmas number one spot?
You just got to take everything in your stride, eh? There's people out there that are going to want to do that, but just let them, you know, if that's what they want to do.
What can you do?
What can you do?
Yeah. Okay, any more?
Yeah, loads. Ashley from Glasgow, did you choose the winner's song and is it a reflection of your taste in music?
It is a reflection of my taste in music, yeah, definitely. It was offered up and I grabbed the opportunity to sing it.
Oh, that's good. Mm-hmm.
Fabulous. And Michelle on Facebook says, apart from winning, what was your best highlight from the show?
Let me guess.
Hard question.
probably singing with Rihanna. She came out those B-doors and turned it on.
That was... electric. I think of everyone who's ever sung a duet on that show, that was the one that had the pure energy between. I thought they are going to snore.
I thought so too.
Have we got, let's have a look. Let's just have a look at this. The fire is burning here.
I don't wanna be
What did you... Look at that! Look at that! Look!
Not many men could survive that one, Matt.
Look, he can't speak.
He can't. He can't. Update. Phil's daughters have arrived.
Yay! They made it.
They
finally made it.
Thank
goodness for that. There they are. You all right, girls? Finally, oh.
They're going to die.
There they go.
Hello.
They're going to hate me for that. Listen, mate, well done.
Thank you so much.
Congratulations.
And, you know, let's get it to number one.
Yes, let's try. Thank you so much. It's been a pleasure.
But hopefully at some stage in the new year you can come in and sing it for us.
Love to.
Terrific. Thank you. And well done.
Thank you so much.
I was going to say relax, but there's not a chance that you are going to relax for a long time. You have landed without any wheels, I think. Thank you. After the break, we've got Rod Stewart and a reunion not to be missed. Don't go away.